The best way to lower your scores in golf? The short game. Hey everybody, my name's George Arteta, golf professional and instructor. And I love, love, love the short game. Come on out with us today and let's see if we can help you lower your scores. Welcome everyone to Bomb Tech Golf Academy, where today we're gonna look at your golf bag and setting up and being ready for your next round. So let's get right to it. First things first, try to decide what kind of bag you would like. Would you like a stand bag like this one? This is something that's easy, portable, mobile. You can move it around the range and stuff like that. Or would you like a staff bag that you would put on the back of a cart here if you're mostly using carts when you're playing? First decision. The next thing you want to be prepared for, if you're playing tournaments, then there are the legal rules that you deal with in tournaments. And so 14 clubs is one of the things you should know about. If you have 14 clubs in your bag, you're okay. 14 or less, 14 or more, it's not legal. So decide what clubs you want for that next day and have that ready also. Another big thing, we're here in Florida, so I sweat a lot and sweat very easily. I have a towel for myself, and then I also have a towel for the clubs. Again, something for you to consider. Another thing to consider is the brush, cleaning your clubs. After every shot, I usually clean my clubs with either the brush or the wet towel. It depends on the club itself. So this brush I really like because it's retractable and I can move it around. The other thing to know on these brushes too, they have two different kind of brushes. One for forged club, the softer ones, and then one for cast club. So make sure you got the right brush on hand. Another thing I really like to have on bags is our name tag, so it's easily identifiable for you and identifiable for the club itself. And another thing you'll see out here on the outside of my bag, this is a bag to hold all the tees. So again, something to consider. You're gonna have a spot here for your balls. You're gonna have a spot here for other miscellaneous type items. One of the other items you should consider thinking about is the Sharpie, using the Sharpie to identify your ball and that sort of thing. Also, if you're in Florida or if you're in Colorado, the sun is the sun, so I use a lot of sunscreen to make sure I'm protected. Other things to consider, for me, the rangefinder. Very difficult for me to play with the rangefinder, without one, I should say, so I usually always check for this in the bag itself. And another thing that people have a lot of questions about, how about head covers? If you can use a head cover, I would, in my opinion, suggest using head covers, especially during transport of your clubs. Whether you're going, leaving them in the car, if you're going to leave them in the garage, that sort of thing. But while you're transporting them, I would always use head covers to keep them protected and try to avoid chips and that sort of thing. The other thing to consider in your bag is, on this Bomb Tech hat, I have a ball marker, so I use the ball markers that are the magnetic type that are on this hat. So ball markers, you can never have enough ball markers on hand, so for me, that's really important. And there's all kinds of ball markers out there, poker chips and that sort of thing. Here, I'm supporting my University of Florida Gators. All right, another thing in your bag is the gloves that you're using. If it's not raining or anything, or if you don't have to play in the rain, then you use just regular gloves. Keep those in the bag if you want. Another thing to consider are actual rain gloves, so don't forget about that. Golf is a sport that's about four and a half hours long. Don't forget your snacks, folks. So whatever snacks you have out there on the course, remember those. It's a lot of things to consider when you put in your bag. You can put a million different things in your bag, but hopefully these are just some of the tips that I would share with you and keeping them in the bag and getting ready to play your best round of golf. So I really appreciate it. In summary, check out all these things that we have identified today. See if one of these can help you out for your next game and to lower your scores. Thanks for being with us today. We really appreciate it. Until we meet again, this is Bomb Tech Golf Academy.